Now, the coal ministry has unveiled the much-anticipated e-auction draft guidelines, addressing a press conference less than an hour ago. The coal secretary said there has to be a specified end use for 74 blocks to be auctioned. He said a valuation committee will decide on the compensation and that steps will be taken to ensure there is no monopoly of mines. Listen in.
One feature which is absolutely essential in these 72 blocks that will either be allotted or be auctioned would be that there has to be a specified end use, and the coal can be used only for that end use. It cannot be sold otherwise. So that is one is essential. We will have two broad categories in these 74 blocks. One will relate to such blocks which will be put to auction, and the other will relate to such blocks which will be allotted to the states or state entities. The details are outlined in the ordinance as well as in the rules that you will see, that how this compensation will be determined, what all will be included. As far as the determination of that compensation is concerned, the valuation committee under the chairmanship of HCBC is already going into each. We've got the details from the companies. They are working out what could possibly be the compensation given to them. Once they give us the report, that will be the compensation that will be given to them as determined by the nominated authority. We are also making an effort to ensure that the blocks are not monopolized by one entity, that they take all the blocks. So the nominated authority will arrive at a particular number. He hasn't arrived as yet. This cap will be basically for auction as well as allotment. In both cases, we will not give everything to one or two.
Well, Mehak Kasbekar is joining us from the capital. Mehak, take us through the draft guidelines, please.
Well, first of all, of course, the timeline that the entire industry was looking forward to, that has been made public today. What we're looking at, of course, is that the RFP will come out by December 22nd. The bid due date will be 11th Feb. And, of course, the technical bids will be qualified by 3rd March. And the final letter that the secretary said today at the latest will be given by 16th March 2015 next year. We've been speaking to, of course, experts who said it is quite a tight timeline. But considering that the Supreme Court said that all of this has to take place before 31st of March. That's what the government has said so far. These are broad contours, of course, at this point in time, and they can change accordingly, and that's what has been coming in from the coal secretary. But, of course, more importantly, there will be a cap on tariffs for power companies. How are they going to look at that? That we'll have to wait and watch. Those guidelines will come out in a bit. What is the compensation amount that most companies will have to pay that the Supreme Court had said and what the ordinance had made clear? Valuation committee will be looking at that as well. There is a nodal nominated authority who will be looking at all of these auctions of 74 coal blocks which are scheduled to, that will be taking place, and will make sure that just a few coal block that just a few players don't have the maximum number of coal blocks. However, still question marks on how swapping of coal blocks is going to take place between companies, and of course who will be allowed to bid and who will not be allowed to bid in terms of investment, which has been made. All of those clarities still awaited from the government, but definitely the timeline and draft guidelines coming in, which at least shows the way forward, that the government wants to wrap this up quickly, and most of it will start, in fact, the first bit of it will start in the first week of December itself.
Thanks for that, Mehak. We also spoke to a host of experts and stakeholders in the coal block auctions, listening to what they made of these guidelines.
Given the Supreme Court decision that final view must be taken by 31st of March, this is a very tight schedule, and I'm sure government will be able to carry through this proposal within this time schedule. The PSUs will have both options open. They will be in a position to bid in the open bidding system, and I think the option of giving them on allocation basis also is still open. That option is not closed.
If you win a coal block here and somebody wins the coal block somewhere else, for the same end use, you can swap. So that's a great relief. Unless the individual is convicted, he can participate in the bidding process. So if there is court case or some investigations going on, one is not debarred unless one is convicted, and that conviction is also up to certain type of punishment. So therefore, that is another relief that has been given there. On valuation, there is a valuation committee that has been set up, so we have to see how the valuation committee does valuation of the existing assets.
Are they going to issue an ordinance saying that steel and cement companies cannot raise prices? On what grounds are they going to do that? The BJP government itself in Delhi protested against the raise in tariffs by the regulator in Delhi, and that was rolled back for power. Now, are they going to do the same thing now when actual costs are going up and power tariffs have to be kept low? So I think there is a lot of ambiguity and confusion which I don't understand.
So swapping is one thing we have to still see and find out what are the guidelines coming out on swapping, because it has been mentioned that the geographical proximity will be considered for swapping of mines, and then it has to happen within the same companies under the same ownership. So we have to see more details coming out on this. Then also it has been mentioned that a company cannot go for monopolizing coal mines, so we have to figure it out. The details of this, that how they plan to handle the scenario. Some more clarity about the reserve price and how they plan to handle to keep the tariff low. So these are the areas where we'll have to look for some more clarity.
Privatization for Coal India is a very big challenge, and I don't think that anyone right now would be looking at that. However, to answer what possible solution could be in the way that the Secretary mentioned, that the ownership of the mines does not necessarily mean that there cannot be another operator. In my view, the government will be looking at means to ways to find private operators to manage the mines, which are owned by Coal India. So you would get the benefits of privatization without necessarily having to face the challenges of privatization.